I remember a little one-room schoolhouse that stood just on the edge of a big oak grove. Inside on a corner shelf sat an old galvanized water cooler, and in the back there stood a big pot-bellied stove. I remember a kind and gentle old schoolmaster with blue eyes neath hair that was snow white. And though his thin shoulders were slightly stooped, he moved with a step that was sure and light. I enjoyed those cross-out ball games at noon and recess time, and I always looked forward to our weekly spelling bee. But it seemed my young heart knew its greatest thrill when he would open up an old book of poems and softly read. Under the spreading chestnut tree, the village smithy stands. The smith, the mighty man, is he, with large and sinewy hands. And the muscles of his brawny arms are strong as iron bands. His hair is crisp and black and long. His face is like the tan. His brow is wet with honest sweat, for he owes not any man. These words that had been written so long ago seemed always to my throat a huge lump would bring. For down that dusty road less than a mile away, you could hear my daddy's hammer and anvil ring. The silence of the classroom was only broken by the old schoolmaster as he thumbed through his book. And just before he would resume his reading, it seemed that straight at me he would look. Blessings on thee, little man, barefoot boy with cheeks of tan, with thy turned-up pantaloons and thy merry whistle tune, with thy red lips, redder still, kissed by strawberries on the hill. From my heart I give thee joy, I was once a barefoot boy. From out of the past came these men of words and rhyme, but it seemed that far into the future they could foresee. For the man who wrote the village smithy surely knew my dad, and that whistling barefoot boy just had to be me.